Hello and welcome to ESA Web TV. We join you today from ESA's headquarters in Paris, where we are looking ahead to the upcoming year. Now, there's a lot on the plate for 2019, and towards the end of the year, there will be the Council at Ministerial level, and that will be taking place in Spain. Now, this is where ministers from ESA's member states will come together to secure financing for ESA's activities in the coming years. Now, I'm joined by Jan Werner, who, of course, is ESA's Director General. Now, Jan, the name of this event, you've named this Space 19 Plus. Why this name?
So Space 19 Plus is the word we created for this ESA Council at Ministerial level, where we have all the ministers coming and then providing us for the budget of the future. And this is exactly what means the plus. So we have the meeting in 19, therefore Space 19. We are talking about space, also clear. And the plus means we are looking to the future after this ministerial, where we need money from our member states for all the different programs and projects we are planning.
Now, the different programs and projects, you've divided them into four, let's call them thematic areas. One of them is science and exploration. Now, I understand that, of course, we won't know what exactly is on the menu, so to speak, until the springtime. But can you give us a taste of maybe what we could be looking towards in this particular area?
We defined what we are doing in what we call the four main programmatic pillars because we believe that there must be a better narrative of what we are doing also to the outer world. I mean, the experts know what we are doing in science, they know what we are doing in Earth observation or in telecommunication, but overall the systematic of what we are doing should be in some narrative. So in this first pillar, science and exploration, we are looking to scientific missions in the future. For instance, what we say, we are bringing the sound to the cosmic movie, which means we are linking different satellites, different spacecraft to get, for instance, gravitational waves and X-rays. Putting them together, you get a better understanding of the solar system and even beyond of the universe. So this is one part in science where we do it. And in exploration, we say once explorers, always explorers. That means we are looking to go to low Earth orbit, like ISS, but also to Moon and Mars, robotic and with astronauts.
Now, another area is space safety and security. And I understand that some of the things on the table here are relatively new. What exactly does this mean?
The whole pillar of space and space safety and security is new as a narrative. Some of the parts are already done, but that we have created a new pillar, that's something of this new idea to communicate. So space safety and security is covering two main aspects. Number one is threats originated in space. We call that space safety program. And the other one, where we have the threats originated on the surface of the Earth. For instance, think about tsunami, eruptions of Earth, of volcanoes, earthquakes, but also security aspects. So we have made a difference between threats originated in space, space weather, space debris, near-Earth objects hitting toward the Earth, and space safety and security applications. And both of them are supported and underpinned by cybersecurity as all of our different activities. So we put into the space safety and security pillar space safety, safety and security applications, and cybersecurity.
So it's really about keeping the citizens of our planet safe. What about enabling and support? This is another pillar.
Enabling and support is another pillar, which when I created it, I got some first negative reactions, because in this enabling and support, which doesn't look directly and doesn't mention a concrete technology, we have the launchers, we have the operations, and we have the technology developments. And all three are, of course, big programs. So enabling and support means by creating new technologies, we make possible future activities. We make them possible, future activities. By having operations, we really do the operation of the missions. So it's also supporting the mission as such. It's not the mission, it is supporting the mission. And without a launcher, we cannot have a mission. So therefore, all three are enabling and support. We are looking in the launcher sector for new transportation means, meaning Ariane 6 and Vega C. This is already what is right now running. But we are looking to Space Rider as a new vehicle to do microgravity research with a reusable spacecraft. In technology, we are looking to new technologies like artificial intelligence or new cybersecurity aspects. So it is all filled with activities in this pillar.
Now, our final pillar is applications. That's a very broad term, but what's specifically on the plate there for the ministerial?
In applications, we are covering Earth observation and navigation and telecommunication. So if we look to Earth observation, we call it the health check. It is feeling the pulse of our planet, meaning with different spacecrafts, we can measure everything. Ozone, we can look to temperature of oceans, we can look to glaciers and melting of ice. So this part of Earth observation is covering all the different aspects which happens on our Earth. But of course, also things like migration can be done over there. And then we have the navigation, where we have the very successful Galileo system, which is paid by the European Union, but we have also a navigation program within ESA, NAVISP, it's called NAVISP. There we are looking for future navigation systems on Earth, but also, for instance, for our spacecrafts going towards the Moon or even further to Mars. And then we have, as a third part, telecommunication in this pillar. Telecommunication is a very broad variety. We are looking to 5G applications in the future. So the new standard for telecommunication will be dealt over there with satellites, but also cybersecurity, especially in the communication area by quantum key distribution, is part of this telecommunication part.
So there's a lot on your plate for Space 19+, but what are the benefits for the average citizen?
Each and every pillar of our NOAA program has benefits for citizens. I call it overall, space is an infrastructure. That means you get results from each and everything. From Earth observation, you get, for instance, weather forecast, just as one example. For telecommunication, you get the results of what is happening in the world. For Galileo, for satellite navigation, you get the day-by-day navigated through the world. Through science and exploration, you get information about planets, about the universe, about miracles in the universe, and about really surprising things when you find a dark matter or black hole. So in each and everything of our activities, there is a benefit, and we even know how much it is. If you spend €1 in space, you get about €6 back. It's different from pillar to pillar, but overall it's 1 to 6. And in order to give this information even better to people who would like to use it, we created now what we call a downstream gateway. I call it one space to the customer. That means people, but also companies or politicians can use this entrance to get information and to get use of what we are doing in ESA.
Well, Jan, we look forward to learning more about Space 19+ as the year goes on. And to our viewers, remember that to learn more about space, about our planet, or about ESA's activities, you can visit our website at www.esa.int. I'm Kelsey Brennan-Wessels. Have a great day.